الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا، من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلن تجد له وليا مرشدا. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعه بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وبارك وسلم تسليما كثيرا. أما بعد، اللهم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. اللهم سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم، ولا فهم لنا إلا ما فهمتنا إنك أنت الجواد الكريم. آمين يا رب العالمين. وبعد، My respected brothers and sisters in Islam, Alhamdulillah, in the last khutbah, I have mentioned some more truth of the dua and the long story that how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala comes and help when you are sincere in your dua, when you are mukhlis in your dua. And every Muslim should have yaqeen in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He is the only one who can really solve our problems and difficulties and hardships and problems. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أَمَّنْ يُجِيبُ الْمُضْطَرَّ إِذَا دَعَاهُ وَيَكْشِفُ السُّوءَ وَيَجْعَلُكُمْ خُلَفَاءَ الْأَرْضِ أَإِلَهٌ مَعَ اللَّهِ قَلِيلًا مَا تَذَكَّرُونَ. Is there anyone besides Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who can remove your problem and hardship? And as a Muslim, we should have yaqeen in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that hasbunallahu lideenina, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sufficient for us in our deen. Hasbunallahu lidunyana, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sufficient when it comes to our dunya. And hasbunallahu lima ahammana, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sufficient for all our worries. Hasbunallahu liman bagha alayna, if someone does zulm in us, only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala who can relieve us. And hasbunallahu inda al-maut, even when we are dying, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the only one who can protect us and who can help us to live this dunya peacefully. And hasbunallahu inda al-mas'alati fil qabr, when we are in the grave, only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can help us and protect us from the punishment of the grave. And hasbunallahu inda al-sirat, and when we are going to cross the bridge of sirat, only Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's help can help us. And hasbunallahu inda al-mizan, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said to Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, فَإِن تَوَلَّوْا فَقُلْ حَسْبِيَ اللَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ عَلَيْهِ تَوَكَّلْتُ وَهُوَ رَبُّ الْعَرْشِ الْعَظِيمِ. That O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if they refuse you, if they turn away from you, then tell them and say, حَسْبِي اللَّهُ, Allah is حَسْب, Allah is sufficient for me. لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُو, besides whom there is no God. عَلَيْهِ تَوَكَّلْتُ, I place my trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَهُوَ رَبُّ الْعَرْشِ الْعَظِيمِ, and He is the Rabb of Arshi Azim. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned about this specific dua that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught him in the ending ayah of Suratul Tawbah. That whoever recites this dua, حَسْبِي اللَّهُ لَا إِلَهَ إِلَّا هُوَ عَلَيْهِ تَوَكَّلْتُ وَهُوَ رَبُّ الْعَرْشِ الْعَظِيمِ, 7 times in the morning and 7 times in the evening. كَفَاهُ اللَّهُ لِمَا أَهَمَّهُ, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is sufficient for him for all the worries. And why not? Because you say in Allah, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in this dua, عَلَيْهِ تَوَكَّلْتُ. In Allah I place my trust, my yaqeen, my affairs, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will help you then for the whole day and for the whole night. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has reminded us multiple times in the Holy Quran with different wordings. كَفَى بِاللَّهِ وَكِيلًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is kafi for us as being wakil. كَفَى بِاللَّهِ شَهِيدًا. Allah is kafi for us as being shaheed, meaning witness. كَفَى بِاللَّهِ رَقِيبًا. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is kafi for us as being raqib, friend, wali. كَفَى بِاللَّهِ عَلِيمًا. Allah is sufficient for us as being alim. Alim meaning he is kafi. He knows all of our situations and troubles and problems, and he is kafi for us if we turn our trust from something else to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, كَفَى بِاللَّهِ وَلِيًّا. كَفَى بِاللَّهِ نَصِيرًا. Allah is sufficient for us. Allah is kafi for us as being wali. And nasir means helper and supporter. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked us in the Holy Quran, saying, أَلَيْسَ اللَّهُ بِكَافٍ عَبْدًا. Is Allah not sufficient for His servant? أَلَيْسَ اللَّهُ بِكَافٍ عَبْدًا. Where you go? When you are in trouble and problems, you turn your yaqeen from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to your job, and to your bank account, and to your wife, and your children, and your parents, and so on and so forth. Allah says, أَلَيْسَ اللَّهُ بِكَافٍ عَبْدًا. Is Allah not kafi for you? Of course, you can seek help from people, but first and foremost, your yaqeen and trust should be in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam mentioned the power of the dua. In the hadith, he said, in the beautiful hadith, لَيْسَ شَيْءٌ أَكْرَمَ عَلَى اللَّهِ تَعَالَى مِنَ الدُّعَاءِ. That there is nothing more superior to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than dua. You know, namaz, salah is very powerful. Zakat is very powerful. Fasting of Ramadan, very powerful. Hajj is very powerful. Jihad is very powerful. But the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, لَيْسَ شَيْءٌ أَكْرَمَ عَلَى اللَّهِ تَعَالَى مِنَ الدُّعَاءِ. That there is nothing that is more superior to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala than dua. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, الدُّعَاءُ أَفْضَلُ الْعِبَادَةِ. Dua is not only the ibadah. Look at the beauty of dua. When we raise our hands before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh Allah, give me this. Oh Allah, give me that. Oh Allah, bless me in this. Oh Allah, bless me in that. Oh Allah, grant me your treasure, your children, my good wife and or husband, or maybe good car, good job. You're asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you are requesting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is saying, I am going to give you, not only I'm going to give you, but the more you get, the more you make dua, the closer you are to me. Ad-du'a'u afdalul ibadah. Dua is not only ibadah. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala something, we request something from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and at the same time we are performing ibadah, and not only the ibadah. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, dua is the best ibadah, is the most superior ibadah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In fact, he said in the hadith, ad-du'a'u huwa al-ibadah, or ad-du'a'u hiya al-ibadah. Dua itself is ibadah, or dua is only the ibadah. Meaning there are other ibadah, but dua is the most superior ibadah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he said in the hadith, ad-du'a'u mukhu al-ibadah. Dua is the maghaz of the ibadah. Dua is the brain of the ibadah. It's so valuable. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, "Ad-du'a'u silahu al-mu'min." Dua is the weapon for the believer. I heard Shaykh al-Islam Mufti Muhammad Taqi Ismail Sahib say that a believer's heart should be engaged in one of the two things. For his past, he should thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala whatever blessing he had from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in children, good house, peace, good wife, family, and safety and security and everything. He should be engaged, making thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh Allah, I'm so grateful for the blessing of children, for the blessing of wife, for the blessing of house, for the blessing of good house, good car, and good health, good dress, good food, and so on and so forth. Always, his heart should be engaged, thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for the previous ni'mas that he already attained from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And for the future, we all had. Even, you know, my next day, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala goes well. Oh Allah, my next week is I spend it with peace and tranquility. So for the future, you should make dua. Your heart should be engaged making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Always, like even if you are going to Walmart to get the grocery, you have to make dua that, oh Allah, I get everything successfully and I return back my home safely. If you're going to work, you know, so your heart should be engaged. Whatever work you are doing, your heart should be attached with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Always, you should be talking to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh Allah, I am going to do this work. I am going to this job. Oh Allah, help me. Even when you're going to masjid, your heart should be engaged with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the dua when you are going to masjid is reported by the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the dua is, Allahumma ja'al fi qalbi nura. Oh Allah, put light in my heart. Waja'al fi sam'i nura. Oh Allah, put light, nur in my hearing. Waja'al fi basari nura. Oh Allah, put light in my eyesight. اللهم اجعل في قلبي نورا وفي لساني نورا واجعل في سمعي نورا واجعل في بصري نورا واجعل من خلفي نورا واجعل من تحتي نورا اللهم اعطني نورا. Oh Allah, give me nur. This was the dua that Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to recite when he was going to the masjid. Meaning, all the time your heart should be engaged either in shukr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala or making dua to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Ad-du'a'u silahul mu'min. Dua is the weapon for the believer. Shaykh Yasir Qazi wrote a very beautiful dua book, Dua, the Weapon of the Believer. And you must recite this dua, this book. All the dua and the value of the dua. Alhamdulillah, I also wrote a book about the dua, named Tuhfatu Dua min al-Kitab wa Sunnah, the gift of the supplication from the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us dua for each and every occasion. When you enter the masjid, there's a dua. Bismillahi wa salatu wa salamu ala Rasulillah. Allahumma aftah li abwaab wa rahmatik, two dua. And that there is one third dua. A'udhu billahi al-azim wa biwajhihi al-kareem wa sultanihi al-qadeem min ash-shaytan al-rajim. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that whoever enters the masjid and recites this dua, he comes under the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala against the shaytan. Very easy dua. A'udhu billahi al-azim. Alhamdulillah, we all enter the masjid. Let's recite this dua with me. A'udhu billahi al-azim wa biwajhihi al-kareem wa sultanihi al-qadeem min ash-shaytan al-rajim. So we are under the protection of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala against the shaytan. And when you exit the masjid, the dua is Bismillahi wa salatu wa salamu ala Rasulillah, meaning send salat and salam upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, or you can simply say sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And then the dua the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to recite, Allahumma inni as'aluka min fadli. Oh Allah, I ask your fadl, your bounty, your rizq. Because when we go outside, masjid is the place of ibadah. No business, no transaction is halal in the masjid. So when you exit the masjid, you ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, oh Allah, even when I'm going to my home, it's a business, you know, and then I go to, so Allahumma inni as'aluka min fadlik. Oh Allah, I ask you to give me your fadl, your bounty. When you go to sleep, there's a dua. Allahumma bismika amutu wa ahya. Oh Allah, I'm sleeping in the name, in your name, Allahumma bismika, oh Allah, amutu. You know, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told us in this dua, that when you go to sleep, in reality, you are dying. So, oh Allah, I am dying. Amutu means I am dying. Oh Allah, I am dying in your name, and inshallah, when I will wake up in the morning, I will wake up in your name. And that's why when you wake up in the morning, the dua is Alhamdulillah alladhi ahyana ba'dama amatana. Thank you Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for giving me life after I was dead. Wa ilayhi nushur. When you go to bathroom, there's a dua. Bismillah. Allahumma inni a'udhu bika min al-khubusi wal-khabais. Oh Allah, I seek your protection against male and female shayateen and jinnat. Al-khubus wal-khabais. Male and female jinnat and shayateen.